questions. I'm here this weekend to help sell. I'm here with any questions, anything you guys have. Sorry, my voice is kind of going away, but I kind of got into bridal from my own wedding. I designed my own wedding dress, but this is how I kind of got into it. I love wedding dresses. I was an artist before, and I was a graphic designer, so I was in the art industry. After my wedding, I got into bridal. I was a buyer for high-end salons. I got to work with a lot of designers, and I was a consultant. So I relate to you because I used to do what you do. I understand you. I feel you. So I did that full-time for 6 years. So that's why I connect so well with the bride, because I would, you know, I worked one-on-one. I knew what they wanted. It's great to be creative. It's great to, you know, design, you know, beautiful dresses, but they also have to be sellable and what the bride wants. It needs to be something that the bride is actually looking for. So no matter what, how different somebody wants to be on a wedding, for their wedding, they want to go back to that classic, elegant look. That's kind of what we, our aesthetic is. So after that, I, you know, started my own line. I started with 6 sashes and showed my first collection at the London Hotel in New York. And we did phenomenal, and now we're in 60 stores worldwide. So for as far as department stores, we're at Nordstrom, Bergdorf Goodman, Neiman Marcus, and Saks Fifth Avenue, and a lot of luxury boutiques around the world. So, yeah. So any questions, anything I can answer for you? That's a good question. Everything's made in the U.S. I have a factory and a design studio in New Jersey, so all the gowns are made in the U.S., and that's what the brides love to hear, the moms love to hear that. So it's so important that when you are trying to close a sale or introducing the gowns, you talk about that, because they actually really do care. A lot of gowns are made overseas, so when they do hear that, and talking about the designer, knowing a little background about the designer really helps. The brides love that, and then they connect. They go look up the designer, and they're like, oh my God, you know. And so that's been such a good selling point for us as well. And I travel, you know, to a lot of my stores, and I get to meet the brides, and it's been really, really helpful for us.
Fabrics?
Okay, fabrics. So we've done, we do a lot of beautiful laces, a lot of French laces. We partnered with Sophia Lez, the French lace house out of Quadri, France. We had exclusivity with them on the laces that we picked out. But we are known to have unique fabrics and laces. That's what, you know, in the industry, from the bride will be here. We've also kind of went in the direction of doing the clean look, which is a lot of brides, that's what they're asking for. And that's been, you know, great, and the focus on that this season too, we're gonna work more with that. So we do crepe, we do chantant, mikado, we do silk file. So we have a variety of fabrics that we work with. We do customizations, brushes, you know, we're made in the US, so I've done brushes even up to a week. If we have the fabric, why not? We can do it. So that's the beauty of that. So there are people getting married very last minute.
Oh yes.
What else can I answer for you? So just, I think today and tomorrow is great because you get to really work with me, and you get to see one-on-one how I connect with the bride, how to close the sale, and obviously you
good
want
morning,
to close the sale
again,
the day of, because when they leave, it's really hard to get them back if you don't have a lot of competition. So without being too pushy, too overly pushy, it's great to be able to close them in fair, she's going to be able to measure you, we can send them a sketch, you know, talking about things like that, that's really going to make it special for the bride.
Do you do plus sizes?
We do. We even go up to size 30. That we did really good. Yeah. Great. And some of the looks, like the Waldorf, we do get a lot of size 16, 18, 20. It's a great look for a plus size.
What's your top selling dress right now?
Waldorf. We just sent out a newsletter on it. We did the most on Waldorf. Dennis Mercer, that's you. Sharon told me to do that dress, and at first I was like, it's so simple, but that dress sells. It sell. And yeah, so we that's Sharon's book. We always say that. Naomi, of course, with the bow. Waldorf, Naomi, Peony. They're all in the same family, but they tend to do so well. And then Brooklyn for, you know, not as much because it's a full ball gown, but it's a full length ball gown. With our ladies, as well with the Vienna.
Who sold the dresses here? Who's, I don't know who's in the wearing. So this is the number one wedding suite in Nordstrom.
Yeah.
And you have number one stylist in the company, number three.
Good morning, flagship. Money bags are ready for pickup.
Have we tried on any of the newer ones yet that came in for the trip show?
Okay. You tried it on?
Yeah, I tried on Eliza. And then the
L.
Yes.
Yeah, I love L. It's my favorite. It's such a particular fabric. It's a liquid organza. Mm-hmm. So it's either like a bright love. Changes. So that's another thing. So if you have a bride that's like in love with a dress that is sweetheart, they want straight or vice versa. Let's say they love that, they want it as a sweetheart, that can be done. That customization can be done. Extending trays, adding buttons, cap sleeve. We're known to do customizations. I don't like to recreate an entire dress because you don't know what's going to happen at the end, if they're going to like it or not, but we definitely do customizations. So we're pretty open to that. Neckline changes. We add sleeves on gowns that don't have sleeves or vice versa.
For fit, just size wise, are there any particular measurements that you recommend that we do besides bust, waist, and hip for your gown?
The measurement chart that you guys have that needs to be filled out. Not for, let's say, for Waldorf, no, not necessarily, but a dress that has long sleeves or any
particular
that entire chart needs to be filled out. We always ask for the height. We ask for the cup size, all of that information we need. And it's so important that when you take those measurements, you're very clear with the bride, this is not a custom dress, these are for references only. Because then they're gonna expect the dress to fit perfectly when it comes in. It's not gonna, it's a standard size, but we just need those for a reference so we can catch anything that was in. So.
Any other suggestions for our brides?
Yes, so we can do, depending on, you know, their budget and what we're trying to close, like if they want to add buttons, if we want to do cap sleeves, neckline changes, open bust cuff, things like that, yeah. And there has to be something to be able to make it special for them to say, okay, today I'm going to say yes to the dress. Sometimes, do you guys do the 10%?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay, sometimes, believe it or not, they don't care.
Yeah, they don't care.
They're like, back in the day, it's like, oh, I get 10% off. Now they're like, I'll get it anyways. You know,
I'll go to a store this morning. So that's what I'm saying. So when I'm here, especially we do so well.
Of course, when the designers there, it's different. But you can say the designer's here to measure you or to get a sketch, you know, things like that to make it so special. Because if I was a bride going to a store to design there, I would want to get my dress. If I love the dress and there was an incentive, you know, so it's, you know, things like that. So yeah, we are offering. we do rushes, but 12 weeks is our standard. Yeah, 8 to 12 weeks. And then we have some veils as well. If a bride, you know, it's a dress that's, you know, the price point's high, if we need to include a raw edge veil.
Olivia McGraw, 6'5".
You know, we can give a price originally, this is the price, and, you know, it'll be included, so we can work. Anything else?
Can we shorten the train on Brooklyn?
Yes, I've had that before. It was okay. Too long for a bride that was petite, so definitely it can be shorter. Do you have it in blush or ivory?
Blush.
Do you have it in blush? Have you sold it in blush?
Mm-hmm.
You have. It's a nice blush, it's not too dark. And I have images of it in ivory in case someone wants to see it. And the Waldorf is the same material, so that's good that they actually see it because it's sometimes hard to visualize. Brides can't visualize. They can't visualize. It's all about, as you know, it's all about psychology and being able to go to sale. As much as they love dresses, there's a lot of pretty dresses out there, so there's a lot of options. So it's about being able to get the bride to commit to say the
Olivia McGraw, 6'5".
I look forward to working with all of you guys. So I'm here. Grab me. I'm pretty good on the floor. This is what I used to do. So I